Now that we've discussed the truth condition and the logic condition in more detail, we can state the conditions for an argument to be good with more precision than in our first attempt. Here was our first pass at a definition. If an argument is good, then 1, it has all true premises, and 2, the conclusion follows from the premises. Here's our current version. If an argument is good, then 1, all the premises are plausible, and 2, the argument is either valid or strong. We're using plausible in the truth condition to highlight the fact that a given premise might be regarded as true by one audience, but as false by another. What we want are premises that are regarded as true by the target audience of the argument. So, a plausible premise is one where the audience believes it has good reason to think it's true, and so is willing to grant it as a premise. This helps to distinguish a plausible premise from a reading of true premise that's defined in terms of correspondence with the objective facts. We'd like our premises to be true in this sense, but what really matters to argument evaluation is whether they're regarded as plausible or not by the intended audience of the argument. We use valid and strong to help specify precisely what we mean when we say that the conclusion follows from the premises. A valid argument is one where the conclusion follows with absolute certainty from the premises, where the truth of the premises logically necessitates the truth of the conclusion. A strong argument is one where the conclusion follows not with absolute certainty, but with some high probability. Together, these help to clarify what we mean when we say that an argument satisfies the logic condition. And altogether, these definitions of plausibility, validity, and strength give us a set of necessary conditions for an argument to be good.